that's
so it's hopefully it's going to be all better. In fact, I'm getting a message.
Is that from Clooney? He said it's all better now because we're not together right now.
Yeah, George is wondering where you are.
He knows. Should I do what that Marine did? You know, with Justin Timberlake. I should do that with Clooney. I'll wait for our next hangout and do it. Because, you know, we talk a lot anyway. So I don't want to take up all our time. You know, we won't talk about Clooney.
We won't. So we were talking about, especially women in a professional setting and talking and heels, and it's the same thing. I realized I can't buy junky heels because
it doesn't work.
It falls apart and it makes my feet hurt, and I got tired of, you know, after the first day of a conference, I had blisters on my feet, or I can't make it to the party, or I want to go home early, or whatever. I have to find the three levels, because you can't glam it up when you're on stage, not to the level that you could when you go out to the cocktail parties at night.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you have to figure out, well, first of all, everyone needs to know who they are. And when I meet with a client, that's what I help them figure out if they haven't thought about it. It's like, who are you inside? Who do you want to project? Because you can make that happen. I mean, are you only going to wear jeans? And why have you made that decision? Do I think that's a wise decision? Here's my opinion. Who are you talking to? And I'll tell you what I think, and you tell me what you think, and then you will make the final decision. But there are different looks that you can have. I mean, I'm not going to wear the same thing I would wear to a conference or to MC an event as I would to go out and trim the rose bushes. Preferably, I would have minions do that. But no, it ends up being me. It's always me with the rose bushes. But I've got different clothes for that.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone does. So it depends on who you want to be and how you want to express yourself. And you have to think, and some people have never really thought about that. I have one client who said, I just want to know what shirt goes with what pair of pants, and I don't want to think about it. Like, okay. And not too many accessories, except those aren't really the words he used. But, so I don't want a bunch of accessories. Just shirt, pants, and a jacket like once a month. Like, that's it. Okay. Those were his needs. So everyone's needs are different. And you need to know. And then when you realize you have those three situations, how do you want your personality to be presented when you are at the parties? That's the big deal.
Because sadly, and not just my industry, actually, my industry being social media and technology in a larger whole, not marketing or public relations, although in the social media umbrella, they all sort of go together. But I've been, most of the speaking that I've done in the past has been for other industries. You know, I'll get hired in and I'll come in and do training or keynote for them or whatever they need me to do, right? And a lot of times, especially if I'm going someplace and flying, I'll try to go out the night before and mingle a little. But definitely the night after I've spoken or taught, I like to go to the parties because then everybody's seen me, and then I get a chance to kind of talk to people and answer questions, or they can get to know me or get my business card again or whatever. But so we're talking insurance industries, medical industries, pharmaceutical, I'm trying to think of some of the others. Those kind of like routine everyday things in your life. Automobile industry, that was the not autos individually, auto car shows and stuff like that. So like not regular geek, like I get that culture. I am that culture.
Yeah.
Those people are out of their minds. I kind of got the, like, I would get the impression, like, I had gone to this one, and it was for a company associated with the insurance industry, and I saw things, like, I don't think these people saw the light of day in a year. And what they actually wore, and what the women wore, and I was just like, it's a fairly, what I would consider, conservative industry, right? Insurance.
Yeah.
It's been around for like at least 100 years, if not more, and the official profession of it. in the United States anyway, and what I saw these people wearing just blew my mind because it didn't match the tone or the industry that they were in. And
were they dressed like hookers?
Yes. Okay. Yes, let's just say that, yes.
All right.
But yeah, it was sad because I know that the women, they
thought they looked glamorous.
They thought that's exactly it, and they didn't look glamorous, and I was
I didn't even
want to be embarrassed for them because it wasn't like there was just one sticking out of the crowd. They were all like that. You know, so they all probably thought each other looked awesome and hot, but I'm at a business function, I don't want to look hot. Like my high school reunion, bring it.
Yeah, there's a fine line. I mean, there's classy, there's hot, there's seductive. I mean, those are all really specific words, and those to me mean very specific ways of dressing. To me, mm-hmm. Maybe not to everyone, but they mean different things to me. And there are different ways to address those things. And there are things that I think are appropriate or not appropriate, or can that personality type carry it off? So, and as I have said to others before, I will tell you look fat in that. Now, again, you know my background. You know I was once tremendously overweight. It's not that I am not in touch with someone who has any sort of weight issue. I am, and I can help hide anything. But if you're going to put on something that doesn't fit you properly, I will say, yeah, that made you look 30 pounds heavier. Don't ever wear it again.
Yeah, I mean, first of all, I have a problem with the fashion industry in some regard where they'll put
out... I have many problems with the fashion industry.
But they'll put out clothes in a size 22. Like, really, I don't need a, you know... A
horizontal stripe wife beater.
Yeah, or like a blouse that has no support and has your arms and back way open and you're a size 22. Like, that doesn't fit the body type. And they just take clothes for skinny girls and make them bigger. And that doesn't work. But, you know, I'm on my way down the scale hopefully now too. But, you know, having myself dipped into the plus size, I understand what it's like to in your head, that, you know, you think one thing works and or they sell the clothes that way, so you assume you could wear them.
Plus they mess with you with the numbers and the designers. I mean, women's minds are just... What we have to deal with, each designer fits you differently and depends on where it's made. I mean, I'm not really brand loyal in that I don't care who makes it. I care that it looks good on you and that it's worth the money you paid for it.
Mm-hmm.
So that could make me brand loyal if I know I can depend on that brand. But they're just, it depends. And the reason this is different is because all these different designers have a different, what's called a fit model. Not a model that is fit, but it's a fit model. And the fit model is the person who is their size 2, their size 4, their size 6, their size 8.
You mean an actual human being?
An actual human being who they fit the clothes on. And if their size 2 is, let's say, a size 2 woman from Malaysia, and she has a different body shape than a size 2 woman from the United States, but they're both size 2s, then the fit model is different. And so the clothes fit differently. And sometimes the fit model, they're hippier than you are. I find that with like Land's End clothes are just hippier because their fit model is a different shape than I am. And that's just, it's the fit model with whoever it is.
Mm-hmm.
So you kind of have to know your brands that way a little bit.
And I think everybody, when they find a pair of jeans that they love, they want to go and buy 5 pairs of them.
Right.
Because it's so difficult.
Right.
So same thing. I mean, that's kind of like the only thing I could see myself being loyal to is
a
hard piece of clothing to fit.
Because you are, if you find the body that's like, oh, the fit, that now you can say, when you find jeans that don't fit you, it's like, well, the fit model's not the same body shape as mine. You can say that. But you know what? It doesn't cost that much if something doesn't fit you just a little for you to have it altered. I mean, American men's sport coats are a boxy cut unless they're Ralph Lauren, and most Ralph Lauren are pulled in a little bit, a little more Italian cut. And, you know, when something's pulled in a little, it makes you look thinner if you need to or want to.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't like a boxy cut on you, you can get a different designer, or you can take it and have it altered just a little to fit you better. Men's sport coats in particular, it doesn't cost that much to get them altered and then look good on you, because a sport coat is a big investment. And you don't wear it so much it's going to wear out immediately. Make it look good every time you wear it.
Yeah.
That's what I think. That's just me. I think you should feel good about the clothes you're wearing. I think you should look good in them, and they should be the right color for your skin tone. And the best part is it should represent your personality.
Yeah, which is why I was glad you said purple was okay for me, because I'd be pretty disappointed if it wasn't.
Yeah. I mean,
that was the one thing we actually started talking about before, is the Pinterest boards, how everything, you picked out like a $400 pair of shoes or something, and somebody a while was like, I can't buy $400 shoes, but I'm supposed to match it to look like that. It's not supposed to be that.
I mean, maybe you did want the $400 pair of shoes, or it's like, just get that, because I chose those shoes for a specific reason, to show you. Black shoes are not always what you want, because I know that you like to wear dresses. And I also know that you are not 5'9" tall. And if you want to look taller, you need to create that illusion. That's why you'll notice a lot of the boots I pick out for you are caramel and calf and all that, because it makes your legs look longer. And I will do the same with your pumps, because then you'll have just endless legs. If that's the look you want. Mm-hmm. If you are going for short and stumpy, because, we're close and high, then go for it, man. I mean, and nobody loves black pumps more than I do. I mean, I adore them. But it all depends on what you're wearing them with. And when you look, and I cannot express how much I love black patent leather pumps. I cannot express that. But if you look at just anybody's leg and put a nude pump at the end of it and a black pump at the end of it, and tell me who looks taller and thinner, the leg, and who looks shorter, it's going to be the one with the nude pump on it. Mm-hmm. Because it just keeps going. Of course, if that's your body color, whatever your leg color is, just whatever's going to make it stretch out, that's what you're looking at. So if you have a dark colored dress that's going to cut you right beneath the knee, which is fine, and then you have a dark colored shoe, it's going to cut you at the ankle, all of a sudden you've gone, and that when you look back, you who's videoed a lot, you'll look back at your video, and then you will be unhappy with how you look.
Oh, I've seen some videos myself. I'm horrified.
So horrified. It's all about being happy with what you see at the other end, I think. Oh, God, I love shoes. I still am upset about this perfect pair of patent leather pumps I had that I wore almost every day, and I wore those suckers out. And they were, the reptile black ones I found reminded me of them. They were ridged for your pleasure up the back. And it's just like, oh, man. Gone. There was no fixing them either. I mean, they were comfortable. They were like 4 inches high. They weren't too stiletto. That's the shoes.
I have to start it on the shoes. I have the shoes and jewelry don't really, you don't outgrow those.
No,
no matter what
you
happens
don't.
To you. Although, I have to say, I was, my shoe size increased a size and a half between being pregnant, twice with my children, that I gained a half a foot size each time.
Wow.
Which
oddly, mine went down, and that has pissed off everyone I've ever told. I know. I'm sorry. I don't know why. I think I was just larger to begin with. I just kept losing weight. But, yeah, it's freakish.
It. But, yeah, so a lot of the cute shoes that I had from whenever, I finally, I kept them because I love them, and there's no way I could fit my feet in them.
I just realized that other people are watching our conversation. It's gotten really dull really fast.
But oh, here's the thing. I shouldn't even do it. I'm not even going to bring it up, but the whole thing about Hangouts. Here, I got to bring my shoe. So here's the socks I'm wearing today.
Oh, that
and they have toes.
Toe socks. But you know what? They're in your color scheme.
They are. And that was the thing. Someone had mentioned earlier today, I was talking to somebody, and they're like, that, they had shoes on or something, and I'm like, why? Years ago, I had read this thing. It was some motivational thing that I had years and years and years ago when I worked at some really crappy company about we were trying to get them to let us telecommute, right? It was when computers were first, like, we could dial in and pick up our email, but, you know, like, and then disconnect, because that's about all you could do. And so we had to design tips on telecommuting, and it was, you should get dressed and actually wear your work shoes into your office kind of thing at home, which was very strange. And I'm like, I'm not going to wear my shoes at home. It doesn't really matter. And someone that I was talking to today says when she gets dressed to go on a hangout, she actually puts her shoes on and everything because it makes her feel professional. Mm-hmm. And I was like, I wear slippers or little toe socks, like, from the 70s or whatever, wherever they came from. But, yeah, so the whole, like, I'll do the upper body thing. But, yeah, usually.
Oh, yeah, I'm completely nude from the waist down.
Yeah. Well, I was in a hangout with someone rather famous online, and sure enough, I mean, he had a nice shirt on, and he got up, and he had, like, not boxer shorts, like undergarment boxer shorts, but shorts that he probably would not wear out in public. I was like, dude, really? Did you really have a pair of shorts on? I can't believe you didn't at least put jeans on or something, but
that's funny.
You have to be careful, because you never know. He had to get up for something quick. He threw out his earbuds, and he ran, and I'm like, he has shorts on. That's awesome. And a dress shirt. That was what it
and
was.
A dress shirt. And that dress is shirt. Really great.
It was good.
But, you know, if that's the case, why did he let you see that?
Well, I don't think he anticipated having to get up quickly. So, what do you know? So I wear jeans at least. Thank you. In case I have to get up and run out of the room. I don't want just, you know, whatever, pajama bottoms.
Well, you know, you can always, you know, go sideways. You can just get up a little and move to the side.
That's what, there is a mute video button up on the top.
Yeah, there is.
Oh, look, see, do that when you're about to get up and run out of the room.
Yeah, people need to know how to use that.
Too funny.
Using your screen share was really nice, by the way.
The screen share is nice. I do like it. I had that kind of preloaded, so I had the Pinterest site up prior to that. Actually, one thing I wanted to ask you, since I have you on air and other people are watching, do you have any specific makeup tips for women?
For Hangouts or in general?
On Hangouts.
Well, yes. Well, my first makeup tip is I don't go anywhere without something on my lips. It could just be Vaseline, because Vaseline makes them feel good in the winter. It's shiny. But I love a good gloss. And I used to be a lipstick-aholic, but I switched to gloss. And the NYC and Hard Candy brands that are inexpensive, $5 to maybe $2, are fine, and they're great. Actually, I prefer them to Bonnie Bell, but honestly, I always come back to MAC when it comes to my favorite gloss. I do love Laura Mercier gloss as well, but MAC is... Now, Laura Mercier lip stain is nice, but then you have to have the brush out, but I have gloss stashed everywhere in my house. I also have two little girls, and they've lost everywhere. Yeah. And, you know, right before we did this, I was, like, going crazy. Where is Boy Bait? Where is Boy Bait? Because it's my favorite.
I don't know how many I have here. I have chapsticks, too, because usually one thing I realize is talking on the Hangouts makes you...
Yeah, I have gloss all the time, and it also creeps me out when men have super, super dry lips, and I can see it. Now, mind you, I can't see that in a Hangout. Maybe not. Depends on if I'm talking to their forehead or not. I can't. Nice.
My favorites are the Smashbox and then this cheap one I bought at the drugstore, which is my favorite one.
See, gloss. There's no reason why you can't have gloss. There's no reason... Mascara.
It's the NYC.
Yeah, NYC is really the bomb. And what is that? Is that $253? $3? Yeah, but the price, it's really inexpensive.
It came with something my daughter wanted.
Yeah, I think it's very, very inexpensive, and I have a bunch of NYC that I stash for my kids to use as well. And I do like the Hard Candy brand of glosses that are the similar shape to that. And they're everywhere. So I'm all for gloss. If you're not going to use anything, use gloss if you want to wear makeup. The next biggest issue is going to be under your eyes, and that lighting can affect that. And you can get all sorts of different lighting. You can solve your issue by getting clip-on table lamps and putting Reveal light bulbs in and hit yourself with two lights and test your lighting with a friend Because if you only use one light, half of you is going to be the dark side of the moon.
Yeah.
If that's the light you're going for, well, I guess good for you. But you can do that at minimal cost so you look good in a hangout if you have a dark house or where your computer is dark or whatever. So test yourself in your lighting. What I love and what I don't leave the house without is usually Dan Reed Cosmetics foundation, which I use not as a foundation because I rarely wear foundation ever because I am blessed with great genetics, to be perfectly honest, is I use it under my eyes because I am so pale, I get that veiny blue business, and oh, I hate it. So that's what I use under my eyes, and I use that every day. Smashbox makes some stuff called artificial light, which you could use in lieu of foundation, which is this great luminescence thing, and it comes in three different shades, and that's it, just three shades. Pick a shade. The darkest shade is for people of, I would say, Indian from India descent or African American, that skin tone. Other than that, if you're any other color, you can use either of the two shades. That's it. Some powder, you're good. It depends on how you want to look. I mean, you know me, I'm not going to get on a hangout unless I have eyeliner, lip gloss, and mascara, because that's crazy talk. Yeah, it's just it's like Dolly Parton. I'm not leaving the house. I mean, Dolly is unrecognizable unless she's made up.
Yeah, and I've seen her. She puts I haven't seen her do a hangout, but she puts little videos out on because she's on Google Plus, and she did a video specifically. She does videos specifically for Google Plus where she actually says it. And she, I mean, really, there's never like the paparazzi. I don't think could ever catch that woman.
No,
off deck.
They haven't. I think it's fantastic. Way to go, Dolly.
It's something about those Tennessee women. I don't really understand what it is. They love to
That's
be
right.
them all the time.
I do. But, you know, but I do take my makeup off at night. My girlfriend, Shan, because of the flood in Tennessee a year or two ago, we ended up staying at my BFF Stephanie's house. And Shan and I shared a room. She never took her makeup off once. Like, seriously? So she slept in it for, I think, 3 days and just touched up every day. It's like, wow. Like, Mr. DeMille, you know? And she's, dare I say, younger than I am. But so, like, I'd rip this stuff off and put it back on again.
Yeah, I'm anal. I mean, I think probably
yes.
less than six times in my life I've fallen asleep with
Exactly. I always take my makeup off. Always, 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 always. Now, my hair is not always as done in a hangout, but, you know, I will have some form of makeup on if someone buzzes me into a hangout. Of course, I could always not answer.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, especially with my hair coloring, with the purple in it and stuff, I tend not to wash it every day, and you can't tell that on a hangout.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
so
no,
where
you can't.
I used to just throw on a baseball hat, or it was like a painter's hat kind of
thing.
I think it's been thrown out. I'm not sure. I'm not sure if I'm allowed to.
I gave your husband instructions that you have to never wear it again. A fedora, sure. A really cute fedora, you're allowed to wear that, but no. Baseball hat.
No baseball hat.
Were you playing baseball?
No. I was not.
You were not.
And I wasn't painting because I think it was.
No. Was it a visor and you were playing tennis? No. Okay. Then you shouldn't have been wearing it.
But the other thing I noticed with that is it made these like
yeah,
because like,
it screwed
shade.
Up your lighting.
It screwed up the lighting and it looked really bad and so I won't wear it anymore. But the thing was is like it really didn't take more than a minute to throw a brush through my hair and fix it a little bit, and I was like I was just like slopping it together. So the makeup isn't hard because I could do powder and lip gloss and a little bit of eyeliner or whatever, and I'm fine. But yeah, it's the kind of the I have to go to work now, where I used to literally get up in the morning, get my kids out to the bus and drop them off to preschool. And I would just literally slop down at my desk in a pair of sweatpants and my Princess Leia Star Wars shirt. And
is it a bikini top, the Princess Leia Star Wars
shirt? No, it's actually pretty awesome because it It's got her holding the gun straight out.
Kind of. Oh, that is so great.
And I bought it like 15 years ago when my husband and I went to Washington, D.C. to one of the museums and had a Star Wars exhibit. And I was like, I have to have this T-shirt. And it's like the T-shirt like I sleep in the thing. And I wore it on a hangout. It was like, well, the lesson with that was is I had, years ago, he and I,
You met at a convention, didn't you?
No.
Just tell me now.
No,
you met at a Star Wars convention.
I met him at work.
Whatever. It's a Star Wars convention. Tell everybody now. It's true. Or was it a Star Trek convention? I mean, come clean now.
It wasn't. It would have been a Star Wars had it been either.
Lynette. And he dresses up as Han Solo. Is that what happens? Is that what happens? And you go, I love you. And he goes, I know. And then he's like, and he sleeps in the thing like this. Is that what it is?
That's exactly what it's like. No, so I go out, right? So at the time we had just had my daughter, because there's 6 years between my kids, and my mom or somebody was like, okay, I'll watch her for the night. We ran out to go to dinner. We were out running errands, and we wound up eating dinner. And it was like a chain, like a TGI Fridays, I don't even know what it was. And I wound up, I didn't go up and talk to them, but I saw someone that I had dated in high school. So, of course, I look like a complete dirtbag. I have no makeup on. My hair was long at the time. It was, I don't know, my hair.
And
was
you went and you went to a restaurant?
And I went to a restaurant, and I had this Princess Leia Star Wars shirt on, and I had sweatpants on and these boots. Like, I looked like
how the girls
run around in college. Now.
You own sweatpants?
I had sweatpants on, or yoga pants either, I'm not sure. Boots. Like, none of the colors match, and this red shirt and probably purple hair at the time. I looked atrocious.
You sound really hot.
And it was, like, big, dumpy coat, and it was all snowy outside, and I was like, I told my husband, like, oh, my God, I know that person. He's like, hey, when he saw who it was. And honestly, to this day, I don't even remember who it was in high school that I ran into or they saw. And he was like, come on, because he knew I was embarrassed. And I was like, he's like, come on, let's go over and talk to him. Come on, you want to go? Come on, introduce him to your new husband, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, oh, I can't. I'm looking down. I'm like, honestly, I'm not even sure I wore a bra that day. Let's just put it on the table. And I was like, because I was like, ran out of the house, and then I didn't expect to go to dinner, and we were starving.
And yet, you see, if I was spent.
It okay, was horrible.
I wouldn't have left the house like that. I haven't had surgery looking that bad.
He just poked his head and he heard the story. He remembers it.
You know, you could have gone to a drive-thru. Shameful.
See, now I won't even go through a drive-thru looking like that.
I
shamed myself to never wear this shirt in public again.
You never know
who
you're going to
wear it on a hangout.
But you know what? You could wear that shirt again.
No.
You wear it with some fun stuff. But you just don't wear it looking like you just described me. That's just...
I looked like a 20-year-old college girl that had a bad night. Like, it was really bad. You know how, like, sometimes I see the girls out the next day from college and they literally look...
They're just shaking the roofie off? Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. And the fact I saw a bunch today, I was at Panera's, and these girls were just, like, sweatpants, Ugg boots, big, oversized sweatshirts, you know, with whatever school they go to. And I was like, yep, that looked like me 15, 10 years ago, whatever I wore. But, yeah, that shirt is... I swear I should go upstairs and burn it now, but...
No, I think it's hilarious.
Something that I wouldn't even... This is how little I realized mattered on Hangouts. Something I would never in a million years wear in public to even drop my children off to preschool. If I had to slow down my car and push them out, I wouldn't even wear this out in public.
You wore it on a Hangout.
And I wore it on a Hangout.
That all these people could see.
Yeah.
You and your half a million followers.
That is so half a million followers watch my stupid Star Wars shirt.
But you know what? By May, you can take that T-shirt and just knot it up with your ripped abs and go, take that, Han Solo. You know what? And rip out the collar and go, yeah. That's how you're going to rock that shirt.
If I'm actually ever thin enough to do a shoot like that, I'll do it. I'm quite a ways away, but that's...
Photoshop.
Your Photoshop is good, too.
Yeah. You know, if you make it real in the picture, it's real. Keep that in mind.
No, it's not real, because it's not real when I look at it, and I know it's not real.
I think that's the best story ever.
It's an atrocious story, and I told it publicly, so now I'm cleansed, so it's all right.
You feel okay now?
Yeah, but I might not. Maybe when I hit a million followers, I'll wear the T-shirt again. So if anybody
wants,
that's a bribe.
Yes. You will wear not just the T-shirt, the whole outfit. Well, just the T-shirt.
Not the sweatpants. I'm done with the sweatpants.
Yeah, don't. Yoga pants are fine. A great fitting pair of yoga pants. Mm-hmm. Actually, I really love Lands' End yoga pants. The material is, I don't know, it's like magic. What that stuff is. Like, those things are awesome. But sweatpants.
Yeah, I don't sweatpants.
I don't think I've ever owned any. I don't think I've ever seen in any. I think they're horrific. But hey, if you like them, that is great. But maybe it's because I used to never sweat, and maybe it's why I don't own sweatpants. But for me, I don't like the material. So I don't like the material. That's where I start with. And then they just don't look good.
Well, I fell into the trap of a lot of stay-at-home or work-at-home mothers or women. People, for that matter. Actually, I'm friends with two people that are stay-at-home, work-at-home fathers. And I know they fall in this trap as well, too. That it's the sweatpants, it's the T-shirt, it's the... I brushed my teeth.
Look, John Lennon was a stay-at-home dad for 5 years. He didn't look like that.
Exactly.
And he was real busy. So,
keep
that in mind.
So I'm adjusting my perception of that, let's just say. But yeah, when I get up in the morning, if I can't get ready before my kids go to school, I get ready as soon as they come home. Because I know once I sit down, your day just goes. You look up, it's noon. You look up, it's 5. And I found myself in the situation that I couldn't blow off the video calls, the hangouts, the Skypes.
Or me.
Or you. The Jane now. I found myself the other day, I jumped on Skype. I had a phone call to make. And I'm going to be perfectly honest here. The person that I was talking to, and I'll out him because I think he kind of knows anyway. His name is Lewis Howes. And he
You informed me about him.
So this Wednesday, I don't even know the date. I think it's the 25th of January. Lewis is doing an exclusive webinar for me and for the people that I'm friends or follow or connected to online and all my social networks for LinkedIn because he's a LinkedIn expert. He's a LinkedIn author.
Does he need representation?
Yeah, I don't know. But the thing was...
Let's look into that, Lynette.
We should look into that. But I'll give you the very short story of it. He's not half my age, but there's definitely the Mrs. Robinson age difference going on. So girlfriends of mine, because he's very intelligent. Let me just put that out right now. He is wicked smart. He's very intelligent, and he's aggressive and very business savvy. But unfortunately, he is also very attractive. So
a lot of times...
And when I looked at it in a different light, I said... Oh, now I see why sometimes men can't get past that, or people. Because even as a woman looking at another woman, if you're very attractive, sometimes I can't, and I hate to say it, it's the truth. I'm going to be honest here. If you're super over-the-top, like pinup model attractive, it takes me a couple more stutters to get to your brains.
It's true. Yeah, I get that all the time.
I could see it where you're probably like blonde bombshell and then like they forget that you're smart. So
getting
all dolled up was like, I'm like, well, who needs that? I'm smart. It doesn't really matter. And for this one instance for Lewis, I was like, you know, well, he's very young. I don't know exactly how old he is, but to me, he's very young. I'm 40. And he's an ex-football player. So I was like, well, he can't possibly start. He's in sports. He's this. But, you know, he's the smartest person I've ever met in that industry, as far as LinkedIn goes and with internet marketing. But I had a phone call with them. I've been talking to them for about a year, right, him and his business partner. And I've met him in person, and I've talked to him and stuff like that on the cell phone. So I'm like, okay.
Hey, Lynette, yeah. does he smell good?
Yes, he does.
Okay. I'm just taking mental notes.
You just taking mental notes. But he's smart.
Good.
And so I'm like, well, I've talked. He should smell good. But I've had professional business conversations with him and his business partner, Sean, right? So I'm like, okay, cell phone, you know, I've seen him in person. Of course, we're out at conferences, so I'm dressed, obviously. We jump on Skype, and I was like, oh, my God. Like, today's, like, not the video day. I had no makeup on, or I had a T-shirt on, or whatever. And as soon as I got on the video, I had to apologize. because I felt very self-conscious all of a sudden because I would not walk out my door and meet them at Panera's or whatever and have a professional business meeting with them looking the way that I did, but here all of a sudden I was on a video hangout. And that smacked me in the face like, oh my God. Plus the fact that, like I said,
that they're judging you.
That are judging me, and that I'm significantly, as a woman, and I'm significantly older than they are, and they're both
yes,
young,
but
and they're early 30s.
But wait a minute, wait a minute. But I've seen his picture, and I'll be perfectly honest. I don't know how old he is. You do not look any older than he does. You look exactly the same age to me.
Maybe, but the, you know, I was very self-conscious of it, and all of a sudden I couldn't get past that into my head. It took me a couple minutes to kind of straighten my head out that I looked so horrible, and here I'm on a video chat having a business conversation. You know, not even like, I don't want to say they're good looks because it's a little bit easier for men to get put together quickly online and they're doing video
chats.
And
yet they fail constantly.
They do. But, you know, for those that are okay with it and they jump on and they look okay or whatever, and I felt very, I don't want to say out of my league, but I
felt you off your game.
It put me off my game, and it made me feel like I was at a disadvantage, to be honest with you.
Mm-hmm.
So there was that, and I mean, it's not like it was my first conversation with them. I've been talking to them for a year, so that's not a big deal. So I was a little bit more comfortable with it.
And you're giving him my number, right?
But I did think about turning my video off, and I was like, I really don't even want this, but
I didn't want to seem
official about it. But now I really do realize that if you would not walk out the door and have a meeting, meet face-to-face with these people, anybody looking like this, then you really shouldn't do it on the video hangout. So that sealed the deal for me.
Can I quote you?
Baseball pitcher.
Can I quote you as what you said, like, after our first meeting? Because we were the night we talked for 2 hours, and then, like, the next day you either wrote me a note or we had another chat, and you said something, and I'm paraphrasing here, I will never again get on a hangout looking like ass. And I had already loved you, but after you said that, I was like, oh, she's so awesome.
I just can't do it anymore. And to be honest, I get tired of doing makeup. But I do see the difference. And I know I have to do it. Because I would never get on a stage and look like garbage. And I would never go and have a meeting with someone. And I would never show up looking like garbage. So I just can't do it on a hangout. It's just not acceptable to me anymore. But I'm also doing this as a professional mindset. Where there's a lot of people that just want to hang out with my friends. They don't care if you're going to hire them for business. They have a job. They do whatever. They're here
right.
for strictly social reasons. But there's still something to be said about how people perceive you, how people gleam insight on your personality or your life based on what's around you or behind you, I should say. So I'm really hyper-cognizant of the fact that when I look at people's things, you know, when they're hanging out, I look at what's behind them. Try to figure out what they're about. I could tell when they care what's behind them.
Right.
And I could tell when they just slap themselves in front of something. And not to say that it makes an instant impression, but it's subconscious, I guess, and it kind of adds up.
Yeah, it really does depend on who you are and what you're using the Hangouts for, but just as long as you know going into them, unless they are a private Hangout, I mean, you and I could talk with no makeup on and have to each other, and it's just us, and no one else is going to be on the hangout, and we're not going to invite anyone else in. And on top of that, we'll probably do it on Skype so no one else will even know. You know what? Because that's the only downside to Google Plus. It's like, oh, Jan, I'm going to have to talk again. You know. But that aside, unless you know who's there, you don't know who's going to show up, and you never know who you're going to meet.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't know what it's going to mean. You don't know what it could develop into. I mean, maybe you're going to meet someone who could be an employer, could be your neighbor, could be your next ex-husband, and who knows?
Your next ex-husband.
Who knows who you're going to meet? You simply don't know because you don't. So it depends on how you want people to see you. That's all.
Yeah.
And if you are a professional person having professional business in a video conference way, you need to You need to be aware of how you're being seen. And all you have to do, in my world anyway, is to look at professional business people's headshots, and you'll just be appalled. Because they're just so hideous, it's not even funny. And I'm talking about doctors. I have doctor friends who, oh, man, I touch theirs up and send them back. And it's like, please, just use that. I cannot look at that horrible headshot anymore. It's terrible. And it's wrong. It's not, why? What's wrong with it? It's just I stood there and I smiled. It's like you actually have a neck, but look at what you are. Look at what's it's everywhere. You use this all the time to promote yourself. And you travel all the time. It's like you've got that horrible picture, and why? Professional people don't think of how they look in a photo when they should, other than their Christmas cards.
Yeah, I do. You should. A lot of For some reason, a good number of the client genres of their business that I get into, they're still LinkedIn is the number one place that they want me to teach on.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the same thing. Like I was at one conference. I did the same series of talk/teaching like 3 times in a row because they were such a large crowd that they couldn't get them all in the room at once. So the same thing 3 times. And I did it the first time, and I had given recommendations that you can't use, especially in LinkedIn, because LinkedIn is like all business. It's like suit and tie, mm-hmm.
Yeah.
professional. Nobody wants to go there and like shoot the breeze. Like it's all business. So you have to don't put up a picture of you and your dog. Don't put up a picture like in Facebook of like you, your kid or whatever. In other platforms, depending on what you're there for, that could be acceptable. But in LinkedIn, they're not there to socialize. They're there for business. So, you know, I said don't use a 20-year-old picture of yourself that's this big and you can't see it and it's you and your husband when you got married and mm-hmm. now you have grandkids. Like, it doesn't fly because when I meet you in person, number one, I won't recognize you. Number two, you look older.
Yeah.
Don't be afraid of your age. Just make sure you wear your age well was kind of what I said. You know, get the picture touched up a little bit if you need to. It's not the end of the world as long as you still relatively look like you and you're
right.
recognizable. But what was happening is they were taking photos. They were updating employee records or something at the time. I don't know what they were doing. And HR said, well, you know, here, we'll email you your photo, and you could use it for, you know, your LinkedIn. So they had gotten it, and it was on their phone. Everything looked like a mugshot, like this.
Oh, that's terrible.
Blank wall, big shadow behind them like this. And they were like, it was like worse than the Division of Motor Vehicles. And I was like, really? You look like a felon. You want to use that? Go back to your 20-year-old wedding picture. It's better. But, yeah, like, I see a lot of that, too. People don't realize what they look like in their photos that they present themselves with.
Mm-hmm.
I like stuff that's a little bit more, not casual, candid. I don't like the, you know, traditional, you know, like, I call them politician pictures.
Yeah.
I don't like those.
It's photojournalism is the trend in family pictures and regular headshots. But still, you need a decent picture that shows what you look like.
Yeah. Well, you need to put makeup on in that picture. You need to do your hair in that picture.
And it needs to be well lit.
It needs to be well lit.
And it needs to be not taken with your webcam. That's all.
My new one isn't.
That's all.
I had my one prior was actually my cell phone that I kind of self-took and I did like this.
Yeah, that doesn't need to be your LinkedIn photo either. Not you, anybody.
Yeah, anybody. I mean, it's even if you had to take a picture with your cell phone.
Go to Walmart at least and have them light you. You know,
well,
at least.
That's true. Walmart always has little, the little like photo things for babies and stuff. I guess you could get a picture there. Back in the day.
As a student of history, you know.
As a student of history, I know. Glamour shots is also not the right path to go. Although, once upon a time, because when it had to be early 90s. I don't know why, but I got this really strange business advice that I know now. It just dawned on me why they said this. But they said that you should say, now, I was a technical professional working in corporate environments. Mm-hmm. And they said, when I send in my printed resume on your nice, you know, cotton linen paper, whatever, mm-hmm. and it was, you know, double-spaced and all this kind of business, that I should send in a headshot. I'm like, I work in IT. What the hell do you care about my headshot for? But now, honestly, just right at this very instant, I realized it was because I was 24 years old and a woman and attractive by all probably definitions, so that would get me in the door. Oh my God, it's a woman. We need her in here because IT is so male-dominated. But so I had gone, I'm like, I don't have a headshot. It was prior to digital cameras. So I literally went to Glamour Shots. And I brought my own clothes because I knew that they had all the boas and that kind of thing. And I was like, I don't want a boa and cowboy hat at school. So I brought my own professional jacket and I brought my like a suit that I would wear and it had a shell underneath it. And I didn't have her do the glam makeup. I had her, it was a lot of makeup for me. But I had them do professional headshots with like kind of like the blue background and I was kind of like this with my shoulder, however you're supposed to go.
Mm-hmm.
And it looked really good. My husband still has it up on the side. I gave him a copy, but yeah, sending headshots for an IT job was kind of strange back then. But now, you could apply to be administrative assistant. They're going to find your picture online.
Right.
So
as a matter of fact, they're going to go looking for your picture.
They're
going to
go looking for
you. By the way.
So you have to, even though it's not a traditional thing that when you apply to be a medical receptionist, that they that you should give them a picture of your headshot, because you're probably not going to physically send your resume with a headshot in, but they're going to find you online, so you still have to make sure that mm-hmm. your stuff looks good.
Yeah, there. In case people don't know that, there are other people who are hired by large companies to look at all of your social media, by the way. Did you know that? Yes.
I had heard that, I don't know if it's a law or what the deal is, but I'm always asked about this. Not always, I should say. I'm frequently asked about it. Can, you know, by big companies that want me to help them figure out the next step that they should do with social media, and they go, can we research and hire or fire someone based on their social, what we find on social media? And that's a huge, hairy topic, but I'm like, first of all, do you have a current policy in place? If you do, then proceed to next step. If not, see you later. But what I was told is that because they don't want to get their hands dirty directly, they'll hire these third-party people. And the third-party people won't give them details because there are some things that cross over. Like when you are interviewing someone in the United States to hire them, you're not allowed to ask them, are they married? Do they have medical problems? Do they have children? There are certain questions you're not allowed to ask.
Mm-hmm.
That they will find that information if they search for you online. Because
mm-hmm.
if they see, say, they see your Facebook profile and it says married, or picture of you with a baby, or whatever. It could be your niece or nephew, but whatever. That they will get, they'll be privy to information that they're maybe not supposed to have to make their decision. So they will contact a third party and say, these are the criteria that we're looking to, a negative thing, like, you know, whatever. Is this a good fit? And the third party will say yes or no, but they won't disclose why.
Mm-hmm.
And then they feel like, oh, they said no, never mind. There's something wrong with you online. We don't know what it is, and we don't want to know, but the fact is there's something wrong with you that somebody else determined, so we're not going to hire you.
Yeah, there are lots of things people, especially people who are, let's say, going to graduate this year, may want to look at, let's say, on their Facebook. Do they want all those pictures there? Because there are employers who will look. And it will say, I'm going to look at your social media.
Mm-hmm. I have to say, my youngest brother is 25, and he is, I didn't instruct him at all with this. He was very savvy, and he's a really good-looking guy. And I'm sure that there were, like, these crazy pictures on Facebook a couple years ago, and his friends, it was the funny thing to do, they would tag these obnoxious pictures with
mm-hmm.
his name, right,
mm-hmm.
as a joke. Well, I went through and I taught him how to stop other people from tagging you, because as a potential employer or current employer, they would go through and see these drunk pictures, not necessarily realize that it wasn't my brother all the time,
right
out, face down on the floor or whatever. So we took care of that, but he did a couple smart things that I liked. He always had, well, he's, we always call him, my brother's very vain, but he's very self-conscious of how he looks, and he honestly looks like, he comes across as a slightly taller, slightly younger Ryan Seacrest.
Mm-hmm.
He never puts a bad picture of himself online. He never allows anyone to tag him in a bad picture, even if it's a picture of him. But what he had done when he was kind of getting ready to graduate college was he got a picture of the dean of the business school that he went to his university, and like the biggest donor that had come out of that school that like runs this billion-dollar company, and he'd met them. There was some function at the school. My brother had met them, and they were these really prominent businessmen, very wealthy, and the dean of the school, business school and all this. So my brother had his picture taken with him.
Brilliant.
So I'm like, that's great, because now you're seen with all of these, you know, great, successful, professional people, and your idiot friends are doing funnels on their Facebook profiles, and there you go. And he was very cognizant of making sure that all of his stuff always looked really good. I think he met somebody from a football, professional football team. He put that up for a while because that was kind of a cool thing. But he was always using his profile to promote himself and promote what he was doing, which I thought was very savvy for a 20-year-old kid at the time.
That's excellent.
His friends were doing stupid things, and it's a long story. We won't get into it, but someone that he had gone to school with got caught basically on Facebook because of the pictures that they had put, that he lied about where he was a day he was supposed to be working. And when you put it out there, they find it.
You know, or if you check in with Foursquare, oh, I'm off today. Bam, I'm at a bar. It's stupid.
It is stupid. But I have to say that is the one thing my brother is probably the most social media savvy person out of anyone in my family besides me.
Teach him, you know.
But yeah, I love the idea that he didn't have great pictures of himself. They were, you know, because he was young, and they're all from cell phones and whatever, and they put them online. But he took pictures that were a little grainy, a little not that great lit, but they were like with these like billion-dollar professional business people. And people saw him networking with him, so that was
nice.
The best idea of doing it. So,
I removed all mine. Well, there aren't any. If anyone has tagged me in something, it's gone.
Take it
that
off,
I don't like. Yeah. I totally control that. There's none of that. And that's part of what I do for people. It's like, I go through their, if they want me to, I go through their social media stuff and say, get rid of that, hide that, move that, no, yes, but no, you know, got to be done.
Yeah,
you have to.
I'm not so bad with it. I'd like to think of it as a before and after.
Okay, you can go ahead and think of it like that, or you can think about it as someone just stumbled on it and said, oh, really, is that how she presents? Because they're too stupid to read the year underneath it, and it said 2007.
That's true.
See?
There's not any really horrific ones out there. It's either me with short hair or me with long hair, so there's not too much difference. So.
Oh, so you'll just be you with the short hair then.
Yes, exactly.
You'll be
right.
SL. Okay, now let's redo your thing. When you get to 1 million, you wear the Princess Leia shirt.
Not if. When I get to 1 million... I will wear the Princess Leia shirt on a hangout, on a hangout on there.
That would be fantastic.
I'll do it.
And wear it all day, and
I'll have like a marathon, a Princess Leia shirt marathon.
Yes, we'll have the paparazzi follow you around.
My shirt. You know who I was on the hangout with? His name's Matthew Rappaport, and he was on there, and he was like, I guess he must have just, he's like, that Princess Leia, and I was like, yeah, so I like showed the whole, like not like, you know, flashing or anything, but I stood up just so you saw the Princess Leia part. He took a screen cap of it. Of course he did. I'm like, thank God my face wasn't on it. But 1 million users, I will wear the Princess Leia shirt again.
I think that's fantastic.
But I will make it look better this time. Can I do that at least?
Yes. Oh, right. And I told you to do this because you haven't seen it yet. See this? The shirt.
Like the pin.
The shirt.
I like the shirt.
Oh. You've got one just like it on the way.
On the way, yeah.
Isn't it nice? Like, get one for me, get one for Lynette. Get one for me, get one for Lynette. It's just that simple, isn't it?
It works for me.
Yeah. So this has been great fun.
It is.
I'm learning to love it. Oh, I already did. It's an addiction. It's okay.
I need to learn to love to shop.
You don't have to. You have me. I don't care if you love it or not.
I'll
do all the work for you. It's fine. It's good. Feed my addiction. I'm good
with
it. I'm happy to shop for people.
That works for me. I'm not sure. I have to look at my calendar to see when my next public appearance is. The beginning of January, I did like 4 talks in 1 week, and that nearly killed me. I'm not used to that kind of schedule, but...
get used to it.
I've got a bunch of stuff, I'm sure.
It's about to stack back up.
Exactly.
You've got several things. In the mix.
In the mix.
We haven't had time to talk today because I had a travel day. So.
Yes, you did have a travel day. I had an insanity day, but we'll catch up later on that. So.
Wonderful.
All right.
Well,
so
thanks for having
Jane,
me. Yes.
Yeah, it was totally fun. Jane Ellen is on Google Plus.
Yeah, just find me. Just
And when I put this out to video, I touch it up and I'll put our stuff on it. But also look her up on Pinterest.
Yeah, I do love my Pinterest.
That's amazing. And I don't know if you offer that as a service.
Yes, I do.
You do. Okay, so if you are interested in working with Jane as far as a stylist and having her do a Pinterest board, I know she will be able to quote you some prices to get that done.
And I do. Some people, as a stylist, they don't want a Pinterest board.
Okay, yeah.
It depends.
It's not always, but yeah.
It depends. Because, and some people have actually approached me to do Pinterest boards not for clothes, but to curate for other items. And that has not been signed yet, but they have approached me, and it's mm-hmm. like, that's still like shopping. So, yes, I do love my Pinterest, though. I must say, the styling and doing the accessories is something I enjoy, unless it's the food porn, but no one has a need for that unless you're me. Really. It's like, hey, did you see that hamburger? Oh, it was really great. What's the recipe? Show me the hot dog now. Do they have chips with it? Oh, yeah, those were good looking, too.
Pickle, pickle, pickle.
But, yes, I do provide that service, and I do travel with my people.
So. Okay.
I have all that fun, but thanks for having me on.
Oh,
and
no
thanks
problem.
For just doing everything I said so fast. I was talking, like changing everything.
Yes.
And the hardest thing I know to give up was the big earrings. You know how I love the big earrings, but that was so, yeah.
I look at them every morning and I walk by.
They can be adjusted.
They can be. Well, when I cut all my hair off, I went to the big earrings.
They just
But I'm growing my hair out a bit, so we'll see how. Maybe I could find some kind of balance. I don't know.
No, they just need to be adjusted.
They need to
the
be
problem
adjusted.
Was they were dark and long. They were, and they were weighted wrong. That's all. The weight needed to be up near your ear, not on your shoulder.
Got it.
You've noticed the difference. I don't have to convince you.
I know. It made a big difference.
And you don't wear necklaces that cut your neckline in half either.
I didn't wear any today, but yeah.
So you learned.
I did learn.
I had to learn too. There
little
was a time.
Tips. Yeah, just little tips to tweak. It made a big difference that I don't know because you're in your own skin all day. You don't see it. That you working with clients, it's much.
And then you have me come at you going, I was talking to one of my clients today. And I said, you just love it when I tell you everything you're doing is wrong. And I was told, no, I actually hate it, but you're the only one who will tell me that.
Yeah, I haven't hit anything yet where I've been completely in love with something and you're like, no, that has to go 180%, you know, percent. It's not going to work.
I'm sure it'll happen. Give it time.
You have not seen the totality of my closet yet.
That's
so
right.
We'll
yeah, give it time. It'll be great. Anyway, but just so you'll know, it has happened to me. I've had my closet gone through. I've had all my clothes gone through. It has been done to me. It's just not me talking out of my yars, as it were. It's been done to me, and it's very painful. It's like, but, like, no, and don't ever wear it again. Mm. Yeah, it's rough, but sometimes you have to do it.
Sometimes tough love, right?
Yeah, only because I care. But hey, at least I don't have to tell you to make your teeth whiter because they're already fabulous. That's another easy thing people can do to look great on a hangout, white teeth.
Yeah.
Or if you don't have teeth because you take them out, put them back in for the hangout. It's just a thing. Just throw that in there. That's all. Just put them back in for the hangout, and you can take them back out again. I'm cool with that.
That's
and a lot of people with fake teeth.
That's because you live in the South.
You're right. You know what I mean to say to you? You know what I mean to say to you? You got a pretty mouth for a city girl.
Oh, no. And she goes
so on
down.
That note, on that note, thank you, Lynette, for having me.
Thank you very much, Ms. Jane, for coming here and talking to us today.
I enjoyed it immensely. Very much so.
We are going to, in the next day or two, I take this down, repackage it, put it back up online on the Women of G Plus YouTube channel, and you can find that and other videos that I've done as well. And we do them pretty much every Monday night. The one thing I did want to say is I'm not doing one next Monday. And it
killed me. This one was just so great. Why have one next week? Who could follow?
Fabulous. that we couldn't do it next week. But I'm actually going to a Geek Girls dinner in Philadelphia next Monday night, and I know I will not make it back in time for 9 p.m. Eastern, so I decided to skip it. So we're fixing up our schedule for February, and I'll be able to publish that hopefully by the end of the week. But Jane was a fabulous blowout interview for the end of January for us, so thank you very much.
Thank you. I enjoyed it, and everyone enjoy the rest of whatever it is you're doing after you've watched this.
Okay.
Just look good doing it.
Exactly. All right, Jane, we'll catch you soon.
All right, bye.